Cis Bakker. I'm a painter and collage maker from Holland. I went to art school in Utrecht city 40 years ago, and I then painted and made collages that were analog, but also spatial collages. And nowadays it's more also mixed with digital collage and painting, drawing, things like that. A first step for me was probably in high school when we had to write papers on subjects that were we had to make difficult subjects, but then we would have to write 10 or 12 pages about it. But then it was the era of paper and ink, and when you make a mistake in the middle of your text, then an accident with ink, for instance, and you have an ink blob in the middle of your work, then you had to start all over again. But then I found out that I could change it. I changed the ink blob into from an accident into something that meant had a different meaning. So it was a to me it was an epiphany to find out that I could change reality, give it a twist, sometimes with humor, a joke, or another reference, and also it was very nice. And then other people in my class, they found out that I could do that, so they were standing in line to make me change their mistakes into something different. That was it was nice. Favorite artists? I started with Albrecht Dürer. He really inspired me to draw after nature. And that's what I did. I drew self-portraits. I started doing it when I was 11. And then my sisters and brothers and classmates and other relatives and pop music idols and things like that. But I wasn't really content with it only. I wanted something else. I wanted another reality. So I... for instance, Escher influenced me when I was young because of his very layered work that was very intelligent and complex, and really I liked to the fact that you draw in, that he drew in the viewer, and you really had to work at what you were seeing. So find out what he was really drawing. It was difficult to see at one glance, and that's what I liked also about making a work in which you wouldn't see everything at one glance. Later on I found references by Daumier. He was a French political cartoonist in, I think, must be 1800s probably, and so he drew politicians and power and greed and all kinds of nasty feelings and things, but I liked the psychology of it. Also, I found it very inspiring, the work of James Ensor or Francis Goya. The depth of psychology in depicting people. So that's what I liked very much about it. And later on, it grew into interest in surrealism. For instance, Max Ernst and Leonora Carrington. Her mainly as a writer. I discovered her as a writer. It was very inspiring. Indispensable. I think music. Music is indispensable to me. I couldn't do without, because the influence of music is enormous. And I grew up with a lot of music, all jazz music, opera. My mother listened to opera, my father listened to and sold old jazz music, and my brother had a vast collection of pop music. and they all listening, we were all listening to their music at the same time. It was quite hard to do your homework in between. But I got to get a very wide taste. I have a wide range of music that I like. And I use it in my work to steer my work. I use it as a tool. So if I'm stuck in a work, I put on a different kind of music to change the vibe. And that helps me create. Now the death of painting, yeah. I think it can survive, but then you have to really personalize your work. For instance, as an example, Egon Schiele. You can copy his work probably, but you have to put a lot of effort in it, because it's like a fingerprint, your handwriting in art. That's almost you can't copy that totally, because what he did was more than that. He put his soul in there, and that's what I like, and what I think about painting is your work can survive if you put your soul into it. Projects of me, I will have some more projects. Yes, I'm busy with a book of poetry, since I'm also painting and drawing and writing. But perhaps I'll accompany my poems with collages, I don't know yet. I'm still thinking about it. But I'll have a painting cooperation with a painter I had a cooperation with last year. And then we painted 24/7, and it was about recycling your own work, recycling each other's work. And this year we'll be having another topic. It will be probably about limitations. And the next project will be making a short animation, following up on an Instagram, a guy I know, he invited other people to join in to making an animation together, with each taking care of 20 or 30 seconds. And so that's a challenge I'll accept. I like it. If you want to know me more about it, just follow me on Instagram. My name is, of course, Cis Bakker. That's, you write it as CIS_Bakker. Bakker is a very common Dutch name. If you want to see more, just follow me and I'll show you. Okay. I hope perhaps one of us we'll meet online. Bye-bye.